cookie recipe is going to be a chocolate chip M&M cookie. For this recipe, you are going to need 2.5 cups of flour, a teaspoon of salt, a 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, 1 cup of butter brought to room temperature, 2 eggs also brought to room temperature, 1/2 cup of sugar, 1 cup of brown sugar, 2 teaspoons of vanilla, and then either 2 cups of semi-sweet chocolate chips, or I am actually going to do 1 cup of M&Ms and 1 cup of chocolate chips. So a total of 2 cups. And then you also need a little spatula, and then I have a cookie scoop and some type of mixer, which I'm going to be using my KitchenAid stand mixer. So the first thing we're going to do is mix our flour, salt, and baking powder together. Together, incorporate some air, and kind of mix around the salt and the baking powder into the flour. Then we're just going to set it aside for a moment. Now the next thing we're going to do is cream our butter and sugars together. So in my stand mixer, I'm going to put 2 sticks equivalent to 1 cup of unsalted butter. So then there's our 1 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 cup of sugar, white sugar, and then a cup of butter. We're going to put the paddle attachment back on. doing this together. So I'm going to put it on 2 and then turn it off. Start to see it come together. So we're just about there. I'm going to stop the mixer and scrape the mixer down. Let it mix for another few seconds so it's nice and ready for the eggs. Stop the mixer one more time. Scrape it down. We're gonna add our flour mixture. So I'm just gonna take probably about half, maybe a third of it. Start mixing it in. Let it incorporate. And then do a little bit more. trying to avoid the flour poop, which has got a little bit. Of m&ms and about a cup of chocolate chips, and we're just gonna dump those in. And with the mixer you can mix them, and you just want to make sure it's on the lowest setting, and do not mix too long because we don't want the chocolate chips to break or the M&M's to break. We just want them to stir. So, just gonna do it for a second. So now that they're done mixing, you see that most of the cookie batter can sit in the fridge up to 5 days. You can also freeze it in little cookie balls for up to 3 months. So definitely a make ahead Christmas recipe if you'd like to. I'm going to actually put it in the fridge like I did the other cookies, and we'll bake it as it gets closer to Christmas since it's a week up. Thank you.